الحمد لله رب العالمين وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم أما بعد. It's worth noting the two different ways in which people derive their understanding of Islam. You have the way of Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah. Ahl Sunnah, they take their understanding from the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and the methodology and madhab and way of the companions of the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Ahl Sunnah says and follows what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says fi kitabihi al-kareem wa'tasimu bihablillahi jami'an wa la tafarraqu. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says and hold on to the rope of Allah altogether and do not divide. So Ahl Sunnah believes on holding to the rope, which is the kitabillah wa sunnatu rasul sallallahu alaihi wasallam, as a unified ummah, as a unified community, not breaking into groups and sects and divisions. Ahl Sunnah also believes in the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, where he said la tazal taifatun min ummati dhahirin ala al-haq la yadurruhum man khadalahum hatta yatihum amr Allah wa hum kadhalik. So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said there won't cease to be a group from my ummah, this is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, that is clearly on the truth, and no one will harm them who attempts to deceive them until the day of judgment, and they will still be on the truth. This is what the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. So be of those who hold on to the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Qad taraktukum ala bayda, laylaha kan nahariha, la yuzigu anha ba'di illa halak." So the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "I have left you on two things. I've left you upon clarity, or that which is clear. Its night is like its day, so it has a clear light, and no one will go will be deceived if they hold on to it, except that they will be destroyed." Meaning, if you don't hold on to that which is clear, which is the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, then you will be destroyed. وَعِيَاذٍ بِاللَّهِ. May Allah protect us from this. The point I want to bring up here is look at those people who attack Ahl Sunnah from the Ash'aris, for example. The Ash'aris, which we have in Seattle, we have many groups and Ash'aris all over the world. And why it's worth mentioning to our brothers and sisters in Islam is we have to look at how they gain their evidences. When you hear a Sunni saying something, you hear them say, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, and the Sahaba, they were united upon this, and the Salaf, they said this. This is what you hear from Ahl Sunnah. But when you hear from those people, they'll say, Allah said this, but it means this. For example, قال الله سبحانه وتعالى في كتابه الكريم الرحمن على عرش استوى. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said this in many places in the Quran, that Ar-Rahman, the Most Merciful, rose above His throne. Ahl Sunnah affirms that, because that's what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam did. But those people, while Ahl Sunnah is saying the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam affirmed this, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala affirmed this for Himself, and the Salaf as-Salih, the pious predecessors, they affirmed this, the Ash'aris, they say, no, Allah said that, but it means this. It means power. It means strength. It means estola. It means this. So you have to wonder, my brothers and sisters in Islam, is who is trying to lead you to Jannah? Who is trying to offer you the path of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Which path is clear? Ask yourself that. Those people, they distort what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, ينزل ربنا تبارك وتعالى كل ليلة ثلث الآخر إلى آخر الحديث. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descends to the lowest heaven during the last third of the night. This is what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. ينزل ربنا تبارك وتعالى كل ليلة كل ثلث الليل الآخر فيقول من يدعوني فاستجيب له. You know, who is calling me? And I will answer him, or who's supplicating to me. This is what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala does every last third of the night. Ahlul Sunnah affirms this because the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam affirmed this. But the Ash'aris, what did they say? They said, no. That's not what it means. So here, they've come up with something. What do they return back to? They return back to their desires and their understanding, their limited intellect. So you'll find, and I warn myself and warn my brothers and sisters in Islam, to look whenever you have someone who's supposed to be your sheikh, supposed to be your imam, ask them where they're taking their sources from. And then when you ask them a question, see what they say, and especially when it comes to creed. If they say, قال الله في كتاب الكريم, قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, قال السلف الصالح, then this is something, this is correct. But if you hear them say, Allah said, but it means this. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, yes, in that hadith, but we think it means this, and we believe that contradicts this, and we don't want to resemble this. If you see that they're using their aql, their intellect, to form their foundation and their creed in Islam, then I ask you, what kind of Islam is that? And beware of them. And I ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil and protect us from all those people who deviate in the religion of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad.